Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. Have you noticed that conversion rate is missing from Google Analytics 4? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can report on the conversion rate from the actions you're tracking into GA4. Let's jump in and get started. If you've been using Google Analytics for a while, then you've probably been using Universal Analytics. This version includes a whole range of inbuilt reports, along with lots of metrics and dimensions you could use to understand how people engaged with your website. Now, the thing is that with GA4, you might have noticed that the conversion rate metric is missing from your reports, and lots of people have been asking me about how to get it back. If we head to Google Analytics Help, then it's even more confusing because they talk about finding your conversion rate in the home report. But it's not there, so fingers crossed Google will be adding it back as a standard metric soon. And looking at the reports in GA4, there isn't a conversion rate metric. There's no conversion rate metric on the home report. Even when we look at the conversion card, we can only see the total number of conversions. Until Google adds conversion rate to GA4, we'll need to use Google Data Studio to calculate it for the different actions we want to measure. So let's head to Google Data Studio. We start by creating a new report. Select Google Analytics and choose our GA4 property. Then we click Add. And add the data source to our report. Let's remove the default table from the report. And let's add a scorecard. Now let's change the metric from views to conversions. This will now show us our total number of conversions. We could use this to calculate our conversion rate. This would be for our total conversion rate. But I want to just focus on an individual conversion action. Since I'm using the Google Analytics demo property for GA4, I'm going to use one of their conversion actions for the conversion rate. Let's head to Google Analytics to see the events that have been marked as a conversion. I'm in the conversions report. And we can see there are four different events that are marked as conversions. These are Begin Checkout, First Visit, Purchase, and Registration Complete. You will need to ensure that the action you want to use to calculate conversion rate is configured as a conversion in GA4. And if it's not, or you need to set up conversions, then check out my video covering conversions in GA4. I've included a link in the description below this video. Okay, I'm going to use the Begin Checkout conversion action to calculate the conversion rate. But remember, you should use the conversion action you want to measure. Let's head back to Google Data Studio. Okay, so if we just want to calculate the conversion rate for an individual conversion action, we will need to add a filter. So let's click Add a Filter. Let's name the filter. I'm going to name this filter Begin Checkout Conversion. We need to ensure Include is selected. And let's search for and select event name. And then equal to. And enter the name of the event. I'm going to enter begin_checkout, but again, you should enter the name of your conversion event. Now let's click Save. Next, we need to add another scorecard to our report. And we need to change the metric. You'll need to decide if you want to create a session-based conversion rate or a user-based conversion rate. I would encourage you to go with a user-based conversion rate, but if you are also using Universal Analytics, then you might want to go with sessions instead. So for my conversion rate calculation, I'm going to search for and select total users. We can see we have the number of conversions and the number of users. Now it's time to combine them. So let's select both of the scorecards. Then right-click and select Blend Data at the bottom. We can now see the conversion rate based on metrics from GA4. And here's an extra tip. Since the names of these metrics are generic and don't describe the particular conversion action, I recommend you rename these metrics in your report. To do this, select a scorecard. Then click on the icon to the left of the metric. And we can then rename the metric in our report. Let's call this one Begin Checkout Conversion Rate. And let's click Apply. Now it's easy to understand what we're looking at in our report. What conversion rates are you going to calculate? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you're not tracking conversions yet, or you're new to Google Analytics 4, then take a moment to check out my other videos. I've included links in the description below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.